Hi dear students, here Professor Anil Darekar. Today we are going to study bomb calorimeter from unit fuel from engineering chemistry. Bomb and Boyle's calorimeter are used to find GCV of a fuel. Now bomb calorimeter is used to find calorific value of a solid and non-volatile liquid. Solid and non-volatile liquid. Now here we will see principle of bomb calorimeter. Principle, a known weight of solid or liquid fuel is burned. Weight is known. So here, a known weight. Known weight of what? Known weight of either solid fuel or liquid fuel. Right? Is burned. Burn, that is a burning. Now, burning takes place in presence of excess oxygen. Okay? So, in presence of excess oxygen. Now where burning take place? Burning take place in closed pot. Burning take place in the closed pot. And the products of combustion are cooled to get GCV of the fuel. And products of combustion are cooled to get GCV of the fuel. So here dear students, as we know, for getting a GCV, that is a gross calorific value, we need to cool products of combustion. If we cool products of combustion, then we get extra heat. That is what? Gross calorific value. Now here we will see construction. These are the components, right, present in bomb calorimeter. So in that first one, bomb pot, then calorimeter, water and air jackets and accessories. Now we will see construction of bomb calorimeter. So this is a diagrammatic presentation of bomb calorimeter. So here one by one we will see. So first one is bomb pot. So see, this is a bomb pot. So this bomb pot is cylindrical. Are you seeing? This is a cylindrical pot. It is made by using a stainless steel material. So this bomb pot is a cylindrical, strong stainless steel pot closed with lid. So lid tightly fit. This lid, that is a cap, tightly fit to the body of bomb pot to make airtight seal. In order to make airtight seal, this body of a bomb pot tightly fit with the lead, that is the cap. Now this lead provided with two electrodes. Lead provided with two electrodes. So these two electrodes are stainless steel electrodes and one inlet for oxygen. And one inlet for oxygen. Now out of two electrodes, one electrode connected to small ring. What is the use of that small ring? Ring used to hold silica crucible. Not silica crucible. Here stainless steel material we are going to use for making a crucible. So here one small ring is connected to one of the electrode to hold. What to hold? To hold stainless steel crucible. So stainless steel crucible connected to one of the electrode. Now one fine magnesium wire is taken. Now this is a magnesium wire. Now this fine magnesium wire connected to both electrodes. So this is a fine magnesium wire. And wire connected in such a way that wire touches to pellet. Now what is this pellet? This pellet is in the form of a tablet, and inside the pellet powder of solid fuel is there. So what is the use of this stainless steel crucible? Stainless steel crucible is used to hold pellet. Okay, that pellet is what? Weighed pellet of a given fuel. Okay, so weighed pellet of a given fuel is placed in the stainless steel crucible. And here at the bottom of this bomb pot, 10 ml distilled water is placed. Okay, and through oxygen inlet, oxygen is filled in the bomb pot to 25 atmospheric pressure. Okay, so this is about bomb pot. Now, second one is copper calorimeter. So there is a copper calorimeter. There is a copper calorimeter in which bomb pot is placed. So this bomb pot placed or kept inside the copper calorimeter over support. Now here, after keeping a bomb pot inside the copper calorimeter, remaining portion filled with known volume of water. Here, volume of water is that whole bomb pot should get immersed completely inside the water. We have to keep water level inside the calorimeter in such a way that bomb pot should get immersed completely inside the water. Now, in water, thermometer is placed. Now, this is a Beckman thermometer to record the temperature, and one stirrer is placed, stirrer for water circulation. Now this copper calorimeter is placed in this copper calorimeter placed in water and air jacket. Means copper calorimeter, this one surrounded by water and air jacket. Now this copper calorimeter is placed over a plastic support. Okay, so this is about copper calorimeter. Now, what is the use of water and air jacket? Water and air jacket used to avoid loss of heat. Water and air jacket used to avoid loss of heat from the calorimeter. Here, whole setup, or you can say assembly, covered with one cover that is called as an insulating cover. Insulating cover. Now, for performing this experiment, that is a bomb calorimeter, we required some accessories. In that accessories, first one is a 6-volt battery, so we required battery. Second accessory, we required oxygen cylinder to fill oxygen in the bomb pot to 25 atmospheric pressure. And third one, we required pellet press. Pellet press, one machine is there. Now by using a pellet press, we able to convert powder of solid fuel into pellet form. So three accessories we required: one, battery; second, oxygen cylinder to fill oxygen in the bomb pot; and third one, we required pellet press used to convert powder of solid fuel into pellet form. So this is about construction of bomb calorimeter. First we studied bomb pot, so it is a cylindrical stainless steel strong bomb pot, right? Lead with two electrodes and one oxygen inlet. To one of the electrode, ring is attached to hold stainless steel crucible. Use of crucible is to hold pellet of a known weight fuel. Fine magnesium wire connected to two electrodes. That wire should touch to the fuel, and at the bottom, distilled water is placed. This bomb pot is placed in copper calorimeter. Remaining portion filled with known volume of water. Bomb pot should get immersed inside the water. Thermometer to record the temperature, that we are keeping in calorimeter. Second one, we are keeping stirrer to circulate water in and around of bomb pot. Now this copper calorimeter placed in water and air jacket. Role of these two jackets to avoid loss of heat. We required accessories, battery, oxygen cylinder, and pellet press to form a pellet. That is powder of solid fuel converting to pellet. Now we will see working, how it work. So here, as far as working is concerned, take known weight fuel in the form of a pellet, keep in stainless steel crucible, hold that crucible to one of the electrode, take fine magnesium wire, connect that wire to two electrodes in such a way that it touches to the pellet, right? Then cover lead, then tight it to make airtight seal. After airtight seal, this oxygen we are going to fill it, that is up to 25 atmospheric pressure. Now keep this one inside the calorimeter, right? Keep stirrer, keep thermometer, then keep this copper calorimeter in water and air jacket. Now before to start battery, operate stirrer for some time. Now by operating stirrer for some time, whole water will get circulated and this thermometer will give us initial temperature of water. So here by using this thermometer, we will get initial temperature of a thermometer, that is a T1. So after 5 minutes, after recording initial temperature, that is a T1, start battery. So here once battery start, current pass through the electrodes. What pass through the electrode? Current pass through the electrodes. Now here electrodes is in contact with wire. So because of current, wire become a red hot. Now that red hot wire in contact with pellet. So here because of that red hot wire, pellet catch fire, means fuel start burning. And once fuel start burning, it produce heat. Produced heat come out from bomb pot. It enter in water, that water present in the calorimeter. So water absorb heat. So temperature of water start increasing. And after some time, this thermometer will give us highest temperature. That is the final temperature, T2. Okay. So here during the burning of fuel, carbon burn. Along with carbon, if nitrogen and sulfur present in fuel, then nitrogen and sulfur convert into their oxides. Produced oxides dissolve in water and produce acids. So here, why we kept 10 ml distilled water in bomb pot? We are keeping water in bomb pot to dissolve produced oxides, right, to minimize pressure inside the bomb pot. So this is a simple working of bomb calorimeter. I will repeat again. Here for initial period of time, right, here operate stirrer so that water will circulate and thermometer will give us initial temperature, that is a T1. After noting a T1 temperature, start battery. Current will pass through the electrodes. Electrodes in contact with wire, because of current, wire become a red hot wire in contact with pellet. So pellet catch fire, burning start. Once burning start, heat produced heat enter in the water present in calorimeter. So water absorb heat and temperature start increasing, and after some time we will get highest temperature in Beckmann thermometer. That temperature we are going to note as the final temperature, T2. During burning of fuel, along with carbon, nitrogen and sulfur burn. So nitrogen convert into nitrogen oxide, sulfur convert into sulfur oxide. That oxides get dissolved in water, that is the distilled water, to produce acids. So this is the working of bomb calorimeter. Now we will see part of calculation. So mass of fuel x gram. As I said, we are taking a known mass or known volume of fuel, right, in the form of a pellet. So weighed pellet means we know weight of the fuel that we are taken in the form of a pellet. Okay, so mass of fuel, which is equal to x gram. Second one, mass of water in calorimeter, capital W gram. Now which mass of water I am talking here? See, this is the water that present in the calorimeter. So mass of this water, right, that is a capital W gram. Then water equivalent of a calorimeter set. Now calorimeter set means what? Inside the calorimeter, stirrer is there and thermometer is there. So here, after production of heat by fuel, most of the heat absorbed by water present in calorimeter, but some portion of heat absorbed by this stainless steel stirrer and thermometer. So here heat absorbed by stirrer and thermometer. So thermometer and stirrer coming in the calorimeter. So that is called as a calorimeter set, and calorimeter set value is W gram, small W gram. Rise in temperature T2 minus T1. As I said, before to start experiment, we are getting T1 value, and after experiment, we are getting highest temperature, that is the final temperature, T2. Okay, and here finally what we are finding? We are finding simply GCV of fuel, that is L calorie per gram. Now we will see formula by taking help of these readings. So here you can see formula. So here GCV, that is L, which is equal to W plus W into T2 minus T1 upon X. So W plus W, this is the mass of water in calorimeter, small W, calorimeter set, T2 minus T1, rise in temperature, X, mass of fuel, unit, calorie per gram. Now this formula is not correct, this one not giving correct value of GCV, so some corrections required in formula. So what are the correction that we required in formula for getting accurate result? So total three corrections are there. In that first one, fuse wire correction. Fuse wire correction, yep. Acid correction, A. And last one, cooling correction, TC. Now, here, out of three, first two correction must be subtracted from formula. Must be subtracted from formula. So, yep, we are going to subtract from formula. A, that is acid correction, we are going to subtract from formula. Now, here we will see why we are going to subtract from formula. Okay. Fuse wire correction. As we studied in the working of bomb calorimeter, so this is a fuse wire. Now this fuse wire become a red hot. How it become a red hot? The time when current pass through the electrodes, this wire become a red hot. Why we are making this wire? Why we are using this wire? This wire we are using as a, you can say, ignition purpose. Okay, so this wire is red hot. So this red hot wire release some heat. Red hot wire release heat so that burning of or ignition of fuel start. So here for ignition of fuel, this fuse wire release some heat. So that released heat added in formula. Right? So here who releases heat? This red hot wire releases heat. And we are not interested in the heat released by wire. We are interested in the heat produced by fuel only. So here, for getting a correct or accurate value of GCV, need to subtract whatever heat produced by fuse wire. That's why here it is a necessary, or that fuse wire correction must be subtracted. Now, acid correction. Why it must be subtracted? As production of acids are exothermic reaction. As I said, during burning of fuel, if nitrogen and sulfur present, then they get converted into their oxides, and produced oxides dissolved in distilled water, and they produces acids, that is nitric acid and sulfuric acid. Production of these acids exothermic reaction. Exothermic means heat getting released, and that released heat added in formula, means it get added in formula. And here we are not interested in the heat produced by acid, that's why it must be subtracted. Last one, cooling correction. Now cooling correction is TC, which is equal to DT into T. Now DT is the rate of cooling, and T is the time taken to cool the water from higher temperature to room temperature. T, time taken to cool the water from higher temperature to room temperature. DT is rate of cooling, and TC is what? Cooling correction. It must be added in formula. Now why it must be added in formula? Thing is that the time when water temperature reaches to highest, or any substance, right, whose temperature reaches to maximum, it immediately start decreasing, right? It immediately start decreasing before it getting recorded in thermometer. So try to understand why we are adding this cooling correction, because thing is that the time when temperature of water reaches to highest, right, it immediately start decreasing, right? And here thermometer not recording temperature, means before to record temperature in thermometer, water highest temperature decreases slightly. Because of that reason, we are adding in formula. Second thing, as I said, some portion of heat getting added, heat getting absorbed by thermometer and stirrer, right? So some portion of heat loss, right? So it must be added. So here final formula, that is correct formula for getting accurate result, is GCV is equal to W plus W, T2 minus T1 plus TC. Plus TC, that's what I said, it must be added. TC must be added, that's why plus. Minus, collectively, minus in bracket A plus F, means A and F both getting a subtracted from formula upon X. Here, unit calorie per gram. Okay, so in this way, we able to find GCV of a fuel by using a bomb calorie meter. So in today's session, we studied principle of bomb calorie meter, construction of bomb calorie meter. In that we studied diagrammatic presentation. We studied how it work, that is a working. We studied calculation part. We got first formula, that is a not accurate. So for getting accurate formula, we did corrections. And here we studied three corrections, that is a fuse wire, acid and cooling correction. And finally, we got corrected formula for getting accurate value of GCV. Thank you. Thank you for watching.